Tana, 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 tana.
Go shower.
You, I'm freaking huge, brother!
You smelly Nelly.
Yeah, brother. Hulkamania, brother. Yeah.
Boss, a matte lip with... A matte liquid lipstick. Wow. Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44.
Come be the Hulkinator, brother.
From the Netherlands, hence the accent. And yeah, that was my son.
You, mother.
That happens sometimes. In case you are new, and I know I have some new people, but he likes to video bomb from time to time and such. So yeah, there's that. But today we are going to chat about new makeup releases. This video series is based on Samantha March's Will I Buy It series. Her playlist and the community playlist are both down in the description box. My sources will be there. The products that I mentioned today will be there as well. And that is basically it. The eye look I have filmed, it is the second look of the multiple looks video with the Lethal Cosmetics After Dark palette. Here she is. She very cutesy. And I have already stickered mine and the phone. Why? Because I can and I wanted to. So that's basically it. Before we go any further, change the battery because it's flashing at me. Then I will go to the side, assume the starting position so we can get started because I have a lot to talk about today. Hold on, I'll be right back. Okay. Starting position assumed, and let's just get into it because I have a lot. Let's go to 90s Baby Cosmetics because they have released another new palette for all your Nickelodeon fans. It's their Forever Faves. It features 12 beautiful bright shades, including mattes, glitters and shimmers. I think that the color story is fun. And there are some funky pressed glitters in here, or at least the green one looks to be stars. Let's see the swatches. Yeah, it seems to be stars, which is fun though. So I like the color story, but it is not for me. I have explained this before, but again, I have some new people. So let me explain it again. I'm not really into pressed glitters. To make a long story short, my eyes are older. They usually irritate my eyes. I just don't use them. So yeah, if it is a brand that I have never tried before, I don't know if I like the formula, I will not purchase a palette that contains pressed glitters because I don't know, I'm not invested in that brand yet. Now, if it is a brand that I am very invested in, for instance, Nomad Cosmetics, 5050 Makeup, those types of brands, and they come out with palettes with pressed glitters, I will buy it because I just love the brand so much and I know that I really love their normal formula. So that is kind of my thingy-majiggy. So yeah, I really like the color story and I think that it is fun that they put in a different kind of pressed glitter, but it is not for me. Okay, let's next go to this from Root Cosmetics. Let's start with this, which is the Sin of Gluttony. It's the 8th deadly sin and I really do like the outside of the palette. It is basically a palette with pressed glitters, but different kinds of pressed glitters. So if you really like this, I think you will like this as well. And I, again, think it's kind of fun that they have done different kinds of pressed glitters, you know. So yeah, it's fun. I don't know when it will release because it says coming soon. Then the next thing, why am I itchy? I don't know. Then the next thing that I have from Root Cosmetics are new palettes. They are called Pick a Card. They are the Queen of Hearts, Queen of Diamonds, and I think those are the only two. But they have a lip gloss trio, Rich Shadows, and a luxurious blush and highlight. So it's basically a palette that contains everything. Also says here coming soon. What do I think about this? I like it and I don't like it. I like the idea of it. I like the idea that you basically have one tiny palette that you can just take with you if you want to and it has everything. However, you kind of either need to have a lip brush or use your fingers to apply your lip product with. And I think they should have covered up the cream products. So like, I think Natasha Denona has it, that she has that flap, that sheet on top of the cream products. Because this will get very, very messy. You know, if you kind of, I don't know, drop your bag and the stuff flies everywhere. Yeah, I think in theory it's a nice idea. Especially if you are, I don't know, just starting your makeup collection, or you have one of your son, daughters who is just getting into makeup, to give them something like this for a birthday present or for the holidays. I think this is a very cute format. I just wish that they would have, yeah, kind of closed off the cream part, because I personally don't like cream and powder in one palette. And maybe they should have included a brush as well, you know? I don't know. But I do think that the format is fun. Yeah, let me know down below what you think of it. Let's go next to this, which is a collaboration between Naomi Smalls and Kimchi Chic. And this looks fun. This looks like a very fun palette. I like it. And I think that the mirror is a picture of them together. I think that's really fun. So this is called the Mad Maxine Shoot Yourself eyeshadow palette. It consists of 24 vibrant shades and it retails for $30. It launches soon on kimchichicbeauty.com. I know that for us, at least here in the Netherlands, Kimchi Chic is also sold at Boozy Shop. I think Beauty Bay just got it as well. Now, I know that Boozy Shop sells internationally, but I also know that some stuff is just sold in the Netherlands and some stuff is international. So I will leave the international site down below. Go check it out. And again, I think Beauty Bay sells Kimchi Chic now as well. I think this is fun. Yeah, this is a very fun color story, and I would actually love to try this one. So maybe if it comes here, maybe I will try it. Let me know if that will be of interest to you. Let's next go to Diamond Girl Cosmetics, because they have released some bundles, I think. 25 bucks bundle deals. Bundle A is lip gloss, liquid lipstick, and matte lip gloss, and matte liquid lipstick. Wow. And a pair of mink eyelashes. Why? Why mink? Why? And then bundle B include an eyeshadow palette, a lip gloss, and a matte liquid lipstick. Yeah, so let's go to the palettes then, because the Golden Lady palette is not really for me. The colorful palette, the kaleidoscope palette, I think the colors look very cute. It actually reminds me a little bit of the Hasina One color story from Blushtribe. But because they sell mink lashes, I will not get anything from this brand because they sell mink lashes. If they would not sell mink lashes, I would be very interested, because the lip colors also look very, very cutesy. If I were to get a bundle, it would be bundle B in the kaleidoscope. And then the lip gloss, I don't know. Maybe peachy. But the liquid lipsticks. Spice looks cute. Vixen looks cute. Yeah, I think I would be interested in that bundle if they didn't sell mink lashes. But let me know down below what you think of it. Let's next go to, what's this? Oh yeah, Wicked Sister Cosmetics, because they have released new shades of their creamy matte velvet lipsticks. And they look really pretty. There are some very, very pretty shades here. Just saying. I have not tried Wicked Sisters Cosmetics at all. Does my friend Anki have a code with them? I don't remember, but if she does, it will be flashing in the screen. And I will leave it down in the description box. I will leave her channel down below as well. Go check her out, because she's just the greatest. But I think that the colors look very cute. Do I know what they retail for? Maybe. Oh, they are launching on National Lipstick Day. Is that the 29th? Oh, so they are not live yet. They launch on the 29th of July, apparently. And I don't really know what they retail for. But yeah, they are coming. Okay, next I have here a new release from Trixie Cosmetics, because she is launching the Insider Collection. I love the promo picture. I love the way that this looks. Let's see. It is 5 new lip products. Let's see. The lipsticks will retail for $16. You get a shade Bauble, which is a peach. Then Stacy's Mom, which is a pink, but a more grown-up version of Stacy. Then you get Lip glosses, also 16 bucks. You get the color Cream Puff, which is a peach, Snow Cone, which is a coral, and then Melodrama, which is a sheer glittery pink. They have launched already today on Friday. Yeah, it looks cute. I like the aesthetic of this. I have never tried anything from her brand before, but I do, yeah, that shade Cream Puff. Ooh. I don't know. It looks cute, guys. Let me know if you have tried anything from Trixie Cosmetics. Let's next go to Jouer, because this is a new collection. It's called Champagne and Macaron. I always want to say it like that. I don't know why. I just do. So, yeah. It looks very pretty. Yeah, I don't know, it just looks, not specifically the eye quads, but the face palettes, they look really, really pretty. And then the lippies, is that glosses or liquid lipsticks? I don't know, but those colors look very pretty as well. Yeah, let me give you prices. You get the face palettes retail for 34. One is called Sweet Cheeks and the other is Cheeky Crush. The eyeshadow trios retail for 42, or is that in a set? I hope they don't retail for 42 each though. But it says here the eyeshadow trio set for 42 bucks. You get four types. But I don't know, again, if it is in a set for all four. Or if it is per eyeshadow trio. If it is per eyeshadow trio. But yeah, then the Essential Lip Enhancer Shine Balm in Shimmering Champagne. Yeah, for 18, and then Shimmer Lip Gloss in Pearl for 17, and then Sheer Pigment Lip Gloss 17, and then you get the shade Parisienne and Feminist. It launches the 14th of July on Jouer Cosmetics. It looks really pretty, guys. Those face palettes look gorgeous. And yeah, the lip glosses look gorgeous as well. Did I try anything from Jouer? I don't think I ever have, as of yet. I do kind of want to, at least I think Jouer is cruelty free. But I'm actually not sure. So yeah, there's that. I thought they were. I will say so yay or nay on the screen. But yeah, let's go to the next thing, which is from Playbox Lashes. I'm finding so many new brands here. It's a cruelty-free brand, so that is always good. So then I hope that these are not mink lashes. Just saying. But yeah, it's a very cute lash style though. But I wanted to show you this palette. It looks... I cannot talk anymore. It's called Vibe. Yeah, Vibe eyeshadow palette. It contains 16 pigmented shades. Available for pre-order now with a free deluxe eye blending brush. It retails for 24 bucks normally, but it's on sale now for 21. And this was a post from 2 days ago as I'm filming this. It's Friday, so this was a post from last Wednesday. So I don't know if it is still on sale. But the colors look cute. Yeah, it looks like a very fun palette. It's a new brand. I don't know the brand. I don't know the quality. I don't think that the price is terrible. I think she is in the US though. I think. Let's see if I can find out real quick. Because, yeah, shipping from the US here, I think it was better. But I also know that, COVID is still kind of there. So, oh yeah, they're Faux Mink Lashes. They are a brand that started in 2018. So they are 2 years old. Okay, free shipping on orders above $15. But I think that is... US only. Yeah, it looks nice. It looks fun. Let me know if you have ever tried anything from the brand, because the brand is a little bit older, or at least 2 years old. Very small on Instagram. Yeah, let me know your thoughts on this brand. Okay, let's next go to this, which is the full reveal and swatches of the collaboration between Playing Makeup by Yolando and Beauty by Melissa. It launches on July the 24th. You see swatches and the palette, and it's basically a half colorful, half neutral, bigger palette. Yeah, the color story looks really pretty, and looking at the swatches and the shades in the palette, there could be a few, I don't know, shades that are a little bit closer together in the browner spectrum and maybe a little bit on the orange, but it doesn't look like a lot of repeat shades, or at least not a lot of shades that are kind of filler shades, you know, that are, if you use them on your eye, very, very close together. Yeah, I like the color story. It's a little bit too big for my liking personally, but yeah, I know that my friend Liora raves about this brand. I will link her channel down below as well. And I think, I know that she will love this palette. It could very well be that she is going to order the palette. Let's go next to Amy Lee Cosmetics. Yeah, this is a sneak peek of the palette she's working on. It's called Love is Love. You see here, well, you see it. It's a sneak peek. A little late for Pride, but we are celebrating our Pride every day. And I think that is amazing and it should be that way. There is a pre-sale going on already. So I'm actually... I see a black and white picture, but let me go to the site. Because I'm in a good mood today. Oh, here is the Love is Love palette. Okay, so it's a rainbow palette. And you will see the picture as well. Mattes. I think the shade Stud is a shimmer. And then you get three pressed glitters. Or at least that is what it looks like to me. And then it is, you know, the same thing as I have said earlier. Because there are at least three pressed glitters in this palette. I don't know the brand yet. So there is that. But do go check out her site because she has a lot more interesting color stories and gorgeous palettes. But I think that all have pressed glitters, which I am... Yeah, it's not my vibe. Let's just say that. But I do know that a lot of people really do love pressed glitters. So definitely go check her out. And if you have tried anything from Amy Lee Cosmetics, let me know how the quality is. Okay, let's next go to... this from Beauty Trap Shop. This is a very, very tiny brand. Very tiny brand. These are two palettes that she is coming out with soon. Unfortunately, it also says here that she's selling mink lashes. So... But anyway, let me just shout out the palettes anyway. So you see here a colorful palette, which looks very cute. Three shimmers, six mattes. Yes, it's called Moody, I think, but I'm not sure. Perfect for any look. I love the color story. I love the color story. She's also coming out with a neutral palette, which looks gorgeous as well. Yeah, two gray shades and then a bunch of brown shades. It's called Classy. I really, really like this color story as well. I really like both palettes. But if she is really going to sell mink lashes, I will not purchase anything. So yeah, that is... it's so not necessary. And I'm so sad about that. Because yeah, I really want to support a new brand. It's also a black-owned brand. I'm not into the mink lashes, guys. So if you don't mind it though, I will leave all the information down below. At least the Instagram handle, because I don't see the website yet. She is getting ready to launch, but she hasn't launched yet. So I will leave her Instagram information down below. Go check her out, because the palettes do look really, really, really pretty. Yeah, really pretty. She's also, I think, working on lip glosses and then the lashes. But yeah, let's go next to... Oh no, what am I doing? I don't know. Moira? I got so many tags this week, guys. It was so cool. Moira Beauty, two palettes. I have the You're Very Cute and I have the Apple of My Eye. Let's see if I know a little bit more on the inside. Oh lord, there are more palettes coming. A Kiwi one. What's it called? Kiwi and... Sinusapple. I want to say pineapple, but I know that's not it. Orange, that was it. Wow. I just don't have any... I don't have a picture of the inside, which is actually pretty sad. But yeah, I have at least four palettes here. So apple, blueberry, kiwi and orange. Yeah, I wanted to say pineapple again. She's based in LA, cruelty-free, vegan-friendly. I have never tried anything from this brand. I don't have pictures of the inside as I am filming this, but it is the Juicy series. A bundle will be available as well. So I don't really know. Maybe I can find prices here. $17 per pallet for the, per pallet. So that is a very nice price, I think. But I don't really know anymore as I am filming this.
So that is very sad, isn't it? Yes.
Okay, so it's good that I actually checked the website, because she's only shipping in the US. That is what it says on the website. So yeah, there's that. So it's really mute on how cute I would have found the inside, or maybe it would not have been anything for me, because I don't know. But yeah, she is not shipping outside of the US, so then it is mute for me. But I did want to mention it. Let's next go to... do I know how to pronounce this? Because it is French. Nakli. Marque de maquillage. Nakli Beauty. Nakis? I don't know. I kind of know usually how to pronounce French, but I don't really know how to pronounce this. So I will leave it in the screen, I think, how it is spelled. And maybe you can help me then. This is based in Paris. She's very, very tiny. But this is the first eyeshadow palette. She's also coming out with lippies. But this is the first eyeshadow palette. And it is called... My French isn't that good though. So let's see translation. The musical palette. Okay. So it is called, La Palette Musicale. It's the musical palette. And the color story in there, it looks so cute. Now, do I have these shades? Yes, I do. But I like the whole vibe of it. I like the colors. I like the background. I really, really like this. It is coming soon. So, and that was from 3 days ago. It's so difficult to talk for me today. apparently. I'm following the brand on Instagram. I will leave the Instagram handle down in the description box as well. I think she ships internationally, as what I'm seeing here. So yeah, it is in French, but fortunately you can use Google Translate and all that. I think it's very, very cute. I cannot wait to see more information, prices and all that, and when it will launch. So it could very well be that we will talk about this again next week. But the palette does look cute. I'm very interested. It's based in France, so yay me. No import tax. And the shipping cost should be okay too. So yeah. I will keep you updated. Okay, let's next go to Asgard Queen Cosmetics, because she has released a new shade. It is called... Van Salier, I think. Let's see, it's a shimmery one, I think. But it is so, so pretty. I don't know, do you call this a mossy green? I would call this a mossy gray green shimmery goodness. I think this is gorgeous, guys. She is based in Russia. I know that she has problems shipping right about now, because... and not just her, I heard the same thing about Sigil Inspired, that's also Russian based. There are quite a few problems with shipping, but this looks gorgeous. This looks very, very pretty. I have some of her shades, the quality is very good as well. So yeah, let me know if you have tried anything from her. She's definitely worth checking out. Just, you know, if you order from her, expect long shipping times. It's not her fault, it's just the way that it is. But I love the entire vibe, and she's very, very sweet. Go check her out. Okay, let's next go to... Yes, this is a Harry Potter collection that is Harry Potter and Ulta. And I think it's cute. I cannot get it because I cannot shop at Ulta, but I do think it's cute. You get 4 quads for the 4 houses. You get some brushes. You get some lip products. I think if you're a Harry Potter fan, you will really, really like this. The palettes, yeah, they are browns with some color. I actually like the Slytherin one. The best, I think. And I also like the Hufflepuff one. The other two, yeah, not so much. But I do like the Slytherin one. Because it has that wonky brown in there. You know, I also like the fact that it's in cardboard palettes. Yeah, I like it. The palettes retail for $16 each. You can get the eyeshadow vault for $50. A Deathly Hallows brush kit for $25. Pick Me Puff, Jelly Puff. Oh, there's a Pick Me Puff for $12. Body shimmer for $12. Lip crayons, $10 each. Lip glosses, $10 each. And then a PH lip balm. Yeah, no one wants that because it's always a weird ass pink. But I do really like this collection. I love Harry Potter. I like it. Let's next go to a new brand that will launch on August the 1st. And it is Biot? Oh, Be Your Own Desire, Biot. And they're launching eyeshadow palettes, lippies, and what's this? Foundation. Let's go to... Yeah, I'm actually... It's a new brand. I like it, guys. So, that is basically it. Two eyeshadow palettes, one neutral, one colorful, and a foundation and a lip. Let me know your thoughts down below. Yeah, the colorful palette looks very pretty. It looks to be mattes and shimmers. Yeah, I like it. The neutral palette looks also mattes and shimmers and also looks really pretty. So, I don't really have any more info, but I did want to mention the fact that this is a very new brand and she or he is releasing a bunch of new goodies. I will leave the Instagram handle down below. Oh, and the website down below, because there is already a website as well. So, go follow them and... such. The next thing is from Suva Beauty, because this is a new Hydra liner. It's called Doodle. It has launched already because I have seen it online already. And it's basically one side white, one side black. This is going to get messy. I like the idea. I like the idea of it, but this is going to get messy so quickly. It's water activated, so you have to be very careful. I like the concept, but I think it will be, knowing myself, knowing how this stuff looks after a few uses, it would be way, way, way too messy for me. But let me know down below what you think of it. Then let's go to this, which is from the Sephora collection. I had missed this, and then one of you told me about this in Instagram DMs and I was like, what? So, this is from the Sephora collection and it is a pumpkin infused brush set. Retailing for $18. It's mini brushes, synthetic vegan bristles and pumpkin powder to help lock in moisture to keep your skin with a visible glow. But how will it then work if you need to wash your brushes? I don't get the infused with powder in brushes, but that is maybe me. Then you get lip balms. Yeah, that's fun. You get matte lipsticks in 20 shades, retailing $14. Exfoliating wipes. What I actually wanted, they also have a pumpkin infused sponge set. You get a short sponge and a tall sponge. Now, I like how they look. They don't remind me of pumpkins, they remind me of peaches, but pumpkin infused. How? You need to wash your sponges too, so I really don't understand this. And is it just before you wash them, or is it... I don't know, let's just go to the next thing, which is the full reveal of the Clarity Cosmetics collaboration between heels and brushes. I mentioned this a few weeks back, but I didn't know what the inside looked like now. Looks very pretty. And is that a glitter or is that a very, very foiled shimmer? It has launched already. So let's see if I have a little bit more information on Clarity's. Clarity is part of the thingamajingy. Oh no, it will launch the 31st of July. And it also says here. I don't know if it is a glitter, that very popping shade of that is a glitter, or a very, very foiled shimmer. I don't know, the color story looks cute though. Yeah, I've never tried Clarity Cosmetics, but this does look cute. Let me know down below your thoughts. Let's go next to something that is very exciting. Now, Ofra kind of hinted at a new collab, and the new collab is with Jen from Jen Loves Reviews. And I have watched her video about it, and these are Transformer Lippy Shades. I love Jen, and I hope this will be a huge success. The trio set It costs $50 for the trio, and you can get them individually for $20. You can use code Jen for 20% off of your entire purchase at any time. It's an affiliate code, and they ship to most countries. I think that we will get this at Beauty Bay as well, because the Samantha March collab also came to Beauty Bay. The Samantha March collab also came to Boozy Shop. However, while I love Boozy Shop, Beauty Bay was a lot cheaper. Just saying. So, yeah. I would love to try these. I actually love the colors that she picked. I would use them on their own. But these are Transformer shades. And they can be worn alone. But she has kind of... She explained it as well. That she's also usually about the mixing of the lips. And the layering of the lip colors. To get her perfect shade for a look that she has done. And I think actually this is a brilliant move. Because yes, you can do it with everything. She's just saying, I made these specifically for that. Now, she also says, and we all know that you can do it with any formula, usually, and I have layered actually lipsticks today as well, and I layer sometimes, but not often. But I think it's brilliant that she has made a specific mixing slash layering kit. I think it's brilliant. I love the colors in the kit. And yeah, it could very well be that I will, as I said, pick it up if it comes here. I hope this will be a huge success. Again, I love Jen. And I think this is just a brilliant move that she did. So yeah, I also love the liquid lipstick formula from Ofra. I'm very curious to see if this will be a different formula though. Or if it is the same formula. Let me know down below what you think of it. And yeah, it's just congrats Jen. This is just amazing. Yeah, I love that you have collabed with Ofra. I think the brand is amazing and I think you are amazing. And again, I hope this will be a huge, huge success. If it comes here, I will probably try it out. Just saying.
Okay. Editing me here, because yeah, the whole internet is a buzz, because there was another collab that went live yesterday, and that is between Raw Beauty Christie and Pure. Now, when I saw the collab released or announced, I was like, you know what, I will talk about it next week. But I didn't think it would happen this quickly. As I said, the collection released yesterday. And what is in the collection? It's an eyeshadow palette or a pressed pigments palette and two pairs of falsies. The palette is one side colorful, one side neutral. So you can see it here. That's why I'm kind of moving. I'm almost falling out of my chair, but that's okay. There was also a lot of drama surrounding that collab because, yeah, when it went live yesterday, the site crashed, which is not really weird. And I know that Pure said that they didn't think that it would happen, that they thought that they could handle the volume, but we have seen it in the past with other launches from other brands that, yeah, sites do crash because there are millions of people, or I don't know if there are millions of people, but basically a lot of people who kind of want to go on the site at the same time, and they just can't handle that. So what have they done now? As I'm filming this, which is the same day you are seeing this, but 5 hours earlier, Pure has kind of put in a queue. So when you go to their site, and I will leave the site down below, when you go to the site, you are put in a queue, you get a number, and then at the end of the line, well, you are being led onto the site. And I think that is a great idea. That way, well, it is maybe frustrating that you have to wait. It is not as frustrating as having to wait with, you know, while you are checking out. So the site is still quite busy, at least it was a few hours ago when I went on the site. I did order the palette. I wanted to get falsies as well, but I don't know, I could only see one style. It was the style that I wanted, granted, but it was sold out, so I didn't get any falsies. I did get the palette though, and I also saw a tip from Teresa is Dead that it helps if you make an account before you check out. I did that. First I wanted to check out and it was kind of taking a very long time, and then I was like, wait, let me make an account real quick in between, because you get 10 minutes on the site. And when I made the account, checking out was a lot quicker. So yeah, also for us here, in at least for me in the Netherlands, what are they doing? They are shipping with DHL, which is good if you are outside of the US, because DHL ships regularly. But for me, my import tax was also calculated into the shipping cost, which I had never seen before. But I'm very, very happy about. Now, I could have ordered, I think, express shipping. But yeah, that would have cost almost as much as the pallet itself. So I did order the pallet, and it is on its way to me. I got the confirmation email and everything. And I even put it on Twitter, because I was like, yeah, why not? Let me try Twitter. So if you want to follow me on Twitter, it's NikkiRaven15, I believe. It will be linked down in the description box. And I think no one follows me. I follow a bunch of people, but I don't know if anyone follows me. It's so sad. So go follow me on Twitter. And all that. But yeah, the pallet is on its way to me. Let me know down below your thoughts. I think it is a brilliant move on her part. I know she loves color. I know she loves neutral looks as well. And I think it is just, yeah, brilliant. It's not unique, because Mitchell did it with, is it Beauty Bay? The double-sided pallet. But yeah, one side you have neutral, one side you have colorful. It is all kind of squished together. I don't really exactly know how though. Actually, I haven't watched her release video, but I will later today when I have the time to sit down and watch it. But I'm very excited. I'm very excited for her, and she is well loved here in the beauty community. She is one of those who lifts others up, who is very talented. She makes me laugh every single time that I watch her. So, yeah. Congratulations, Christy. I cannot wait to get everything, play with it, and then show you guys what I think about it. And that is going to be it for this insert part. I'm going to give you back to my past self. I think there was one release coming, I think. And then she will close off the video. So let me know your thoughts down below. And that was it.
Okay, let's go to the... Is this the last thing that I have today? Yes, it is. It is from Netty Bird Cosmetics. I think... Was this a new brand as well? Yeah, it's, I think, or at least it's a new brand for me. They have eyeshadow palettes, they have lippies, but this is, I got tagged in this, and this is actually part of their summer release, I believe. It's their birth order summer collection. It's available now. The prices range from, what did I see again? $19 to... $25. You can also get some bundles. So I will leave the Instagram handle down below and the webpage down below. Let's go to the palettes. They look cute. That middle one, the yellow palette called The Baby. I like that. It's a pastel-y palette, and I love pastels. But all the palettes that I have here on the pictures are firstborn. I think it's firstborn. Then Netty Bird. And then The Baby. They all look very pretty. Let me know down below what you think of it. That, yeah, the yellow palette speaks to me a lot. The other colorful palette as well. The tiny one, the 9 pen, not so much actually. The other two do though. So yeah, Netty Bird and the Middle Child palette. What does it say? The Middle Child. Oh, I love that. Firstborn, then the Middle Child, and then The Baby. A Netty Bird palette. Yeah, I like the Middle Child, and I like the Baby. Those two I like. The other one doesn't speak to me on a lot of levels. I don't know why. But yeah, you get a bunch of stuff in the summer collection. So go check out Netty Bird Cosmetics. And then that was it, guys, for today's video. Oh, ow. Let me do that. I had a lot... Again, brands are... I kind of have developed a theory why we see so many indie brands now. I think it is because a lot of mainstream brands are not releasing as much because of the whole COVID and lockdown and all that. And I think it gives indie brands more room to show up, basically. I know that, you know, if a big brand puts out a new collection on Instagram, for instance, because it's such a big brand... Those posts get pushed more, you know, and I think that the smaller indie brands get kind of pushed back a little bit more. It could also very well be the fact that, and one of you actually thought that it was because a lot of indie brands, at least the ones that we are see popping up now, are smaller, are, you know, people who just are one person show, or maybe two people, and smaller, and not really bound by those restrictions because they can do everything themselves, you know. It could be that. Maybe it's a combination. I don't know, but I really like the fact that so many more indie brands are coming out, and I love talking about them. And I just really think that they push the boundaries of the makeup higher. You know, they come out with fun stuff and new stuff, and yeah, they're very, very exciting. So let me know down below your thoughts, and if you see something interesting, make sure to follow me on Instagram so you can tag me. And I'm getting tagged more often, so thank you so, so much. I hope I didn't forget anything. Could be. I don't know. Let me know down in the comment section. Give me your thoughts on my finds as well. And that is going to be it for me today. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. Stay safe, stay healthy, try to stay sane, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.